Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss spring analogy for primary consolidation. As we have discussed before, consolidation is the process of gradual settlement of structure or compression of soil due to expulsion of water from the voids under static loading. So consolidation is again divided into three stages. First stage is initial consolidation, second stage is primary consolidation, and third stage is secondary consolidation. In initial consolidation, consolidation takes place immediately after the load is applied and the compression of soil occurs due to expulsion of air from the void. Once entire air is removed, soil becomes saturated and primary consolidation starts. So, during primary consolidation, there are only two phases in the soil are present. First is water and second is solid particles. So, immediately after the beginning of primary consolidation, entire load which is applied is taken by water as an excess pore water pressure. As the primary consolidation progresses, the water starts escaping and the pressure is transferred to the solid particles as an effective stress. So, as water escapes, the excess pore water pressure go on decreasing and effective stress, which is pressure taken by solid particles, go on increasing. And after certain time, the entire pressure is transferred to the solid particles. So, effective stress become equal to applied pressure. Hence, during the primary consolidation, value of effective stress vary from 0 to applied pressure. This phenomena we are going to discuss in detail with the help of spring analogy. So, once entire pore water pressure is transferred as effective stress, the primary consolidation gets over and secondary consolidation starts, in which entire effective stress remains constant, but the further decrease in volume of the soil takes place due to readjustment of solid particles. The process of primary consolidation can be explained with the help of spring analogy given by Terzaghi. Here, the figure shows a cylinder fitted with a tight-fitting piston and having a valve, which is initially closed. The cylinder is filled with water and contains a spring of specified stiffness. Let the initial length of the spring be 100 mm and the stiffness of spring be 10 mm per Newton. That means if we apply load of 1 Newton, the compression in the spring will be of 10 mm. Now let's assume that piston is weightless and the spring and the water are initially free of stress. The load P, say 1 Newton, is applied to the piston with its valve closed. The entire load is taken by the water. The stiffness of the spring is negligible as compared to that of water, and consequently no load will be taken by the spring. From the equilibrium we get Pw plus Ps equal to P, where Pw is load taken by the water, Ps is equal to load taken by spring, and P is the total load applied. For P equal to 1, the above equation become Pw plus Ps equal to 1. Initially, when the valve is closed, load taken by the spring is 0, therefore Pw becomes 1. If the valve is gradually opened, water starts escaping from the cylinder. Now the spring starts sharing some load and the decrease in length occurs. Here we can see that valve is opened and water starts escaping. Hence, the pressure which was shared by escaping water is transferred to the spring. As more water escapes, the load carried by the spring increases. Finally, at the time t equal to Tf, entire load is taken by the spring, and hence Pw equal to zero. That is, load shared by water is zero, and load shared by spring, that is Ps, equal to one. As the load carried by water is zero, it is again free of excess pressure. Now, if the valve is closed and the load P is increased by 2 Newton, the process of transfer of load repeats, and finally spring takes a complete load and its length becomes 80 mm. Likewise, the process is repeated till the final increment of the load has been applied. Thank you.